What's going on guys, this is Boss Alpha Gaming and welcome to this video of Exos Heroes. And finally we have the announcement for Fate Court Jinai. Supreme Queen Jinai will be coming as a banner in the game this Thursday. I'm pretty excited guys, what about you? Are you excited to actually summon under this banner? Before we begin with this video guys, if you haven't already subscribed to my channel, please hit that subscribe button. Alright guys, so what do we have in Prism Wing and Supreme Queen Jinai Fate Core and exclusive weapon chance increase? Finally, this Fate Core banner will be available this Thursday and we will see a lot of summoning, we will see a lot of Fate Cores popping up. Let's see what exactly we have in this banner and we'll see whether it is going to be worth summoning for this particular banner. Let's see what exactly the skill sets are and whether we should summon under this or not. As always guys, for this banner I am pretty excited but we'll have to see what are the skill sets and whether it will be worth our these to summon under this banner or not. Alright, you can recruit hero plus fate core with a higher probability than premium recruit. And what exactly we have, which is the period which we have is after maintenance, which is going to be this Thursday. So 1st of October till 8th of October, we will be having this banner. And then main hero, you can recruit hero plus fate core with higher probability than premium recruit. Oh my god, look at the skin man. This is pretty amazing. What is written here? Cash, okay. She looks amazing. I mean, a complete changeover from the previous one or maybe the one which we have in the game right now. This is a complete changeover or complete makeover of this character guys. So this would be actually as a skin or as a champion. It looks pretty amazing. Alright, so let's go into the details. We have attack 58, defense 36, health 194 and CP is 10,800. Alright, so pretty okay. CP is pretty I think low as compared to others, but I think still pretty good. As you can see, this will be a gold fate core, so anyway the pity pull would be 28 times which you have to go for, and then the probability of getting this would be 0.5%. But still there will be a lot of people who will get lucky and even get her in one or two pulls as well. So let's hope for the best and let's see what exactly are the skills. We have passive skills which is mana absorb 4. We have active skills, stage dominance, alright, and then active skill 2 which is last encore. Alright guys, so let's see what exactly we have for passive. Removes all buffs from target and gain mana 1 mana. Gains mana 1 mana if health of target is at 80% or more. Removes 1 mana from target and gains 1 mana if health of target is at 30% or less. Alright, so the first point which is removes all buff from the target. What kind of buff she is going to remove I am not sure, because I mean in the game we don't have as such like a lot of buffs, right, which we can remove. So let's go to the second part which says buff increase attack speed of all allies on the same row as self by 20 for 7 turns. Can't be removed. Increases 2 attack speed per buff removed. Alright, can't be removed as this one is actually a passive skill. So anyways, this cannot be removed. Apart from that, what exactly we have? Increase attack speed of all allies on the same row. Alright, so I think she is chaos character. So she will be placed on back row. So she is going to give a lot of attack speed to other champions. Alright, so in back row we normally have units like attack units or chaos units, and then in front row we will have like defense units. Alright, so the speed of these champions would be pretty high if we are tagging along this particular champion Okay, so we will be getting additional 20 speed for 7 turns, which is pretty good. So basically when you are starting the fight, you will gain plus 20 attack speed. You go ahead, deal with the opponents and come back after 7 turns and the game will be over, like in PvP. Everything which matters right now in PvP is who is going to attack first and how much damage they are currently dealing to the opponent. Alright, there is no defense, there is no healing which actually matters in PvP right now, that you can actually defend your champion, heal your champion continuously and survive. Alright, so this particular skill will be pretty much amazing. Only issue which I see is that, let's say the speed of your champion misaligning with other champions, right? Let's say you have a champion which is giving you additional buff before you start with your turn. Now once you place this champion in back row, champion will gain 20% more attack speed and they will go before taking that buff, right? So you will deal less damage. Then what we have debuff, decreases attack of all targets by 40% for 7 turns. So this is going to remove or decrease the attack of all the opponents by 40% for 7 turns. Okay, decreases by extra 2% per buff removed. Okay, so I am not sure how buffs are being calculated here. Again, if it can be removed, then you will gain additional 2% attack reduction, right? However, you have to keep a note that this particular attack doesn't indicate signature force attack buffs which you are getting into your champion. All right, so if someone is using signature force, then signature force buff like attack percentage increase or defense percentage increase will not get impacted by this particular debuff. All right, let's go to the next part, which is superstar. Afflicts the attention mark for 7 turns to the target when the skill hits. Increases all damage over time on the target with attention by 100%. All right, so I think I did read this clearly. So basically it is not talking about all the attacks, it is talking about only damage over time effects. Alright, so let's say you poison the enemy or you apply bleed mark to the enemy or burn mark to the enemy, then what will happen is, let's say you are dealing only 50%, then instead of 50% you are going to deal 100% of your attack. Alright, so it's not like you, if you are going with Bathory and dealing 40k damage, then it will just increase it to 80k. That is not going to happen. But anyways, it is better to have more attack. Alright, but once again guys, this is not going to impact the signature force skills. Alright, or signature force buff which we are getting in our champions, or the opponent is getting in their champions. Alright. Fan meeting, afflicts the anti-fan mark to the target when attacked. So basically it will be marked as anti-fan. If someone is actually attacking this champion, they will be marked as anti-fan. You don't like me. Alright, so what will happen with this? Triggers double team with all living allies if the health of target with anti-fan is at or less than 30%. Once every 7 turns. Alright, so within 7 turns, if someone gets below 30%, and then what will happen is this fan meeting will get triggered, where she is going to include all the living allies with her and then attack that target. Alright, if the opponent is marked with anti-fan mark and their health get reduced to 30% or less, then she will team up with all the allies which are living and then they will attack together. Alright, so what exactly does it mean and where exactly this can be used? First of all, tranquil mark, it can counter the new ability which we have seen for Reed Mary, where she can only take damage from the basic attack, right? Or the default attack. She won't take damage from skill 1 or skill 2 active abilities. Alright, so here when you are going to team up with all the team members, you are going to hit with your basic attack. Alright, so Reed Mary will definitely go down if you are using this champion. Let's see what exactly we have for active skills. Stage Dominance. Active 1, required mana is 1. All deals 51% damage to all enemies. Overtime effect poisons target, causing 31% damage every turn for 2 turns. Which is actually same. I don't see any difference from the previous version or the current version we have in the game. The damage is same, the effect is same, turns for overtime effect is same. Alright, only difference what it will do is it is going to increase the damage of this 31% to 62% because of the passive which we have seen, right? So what it is going to do is it is going to use superstar with attention mark, and then it is going to increase that damage to 100%. Alright, active 2, what we have here, same as it is for what we have right now in the game. 178% damage to all enemies, poisons the target, causing 62% damage every turn for 4 turns. Alright, so similar to old version what we have right now in the game. So there is no change at all in active 1 and active 2. Even the percentage of overtime effect or the turns of overtime effect is same. Alright, so only difference I see is I see that we don't have charm, we don't have mana gain. Alright, so basically, I mean, she is a general and she is going to provide a lot of buff to this particular nation, right? And I don't understand why we don't have these buffs or passive skills with her, or why they have removed charm and mana gain ability. With the original version of Jhenai, you will receive 1 permanent mana for back row allies. Alright, it's missing right now for this Fate Core version. Second one is charm, which is also missing. Right now we know that we have attack speed or increase for the allies, but it would have been pretty amazing if we are combining this with charm. Alright, so where it will decrease the attack speed of opponent as well, then the combination would be very interesting. Can you imagine the combination of having charm plus mana gain plus attack speed increase, decreasing attack of all targets, and then you have superstar, okay, and fan meeting? It would have been one of the amazing champion in the game, but I am not sure why exactly they have removed charm. This doesn't look like a general to me, to be very honest with you guys. She doesn't look like a general. Like, you have Garf, right? She is having command. And then this particular champion, Jhenai, she, in the original Jhenai, she is having a charm effect. Shufraken will have this fear of abyss effect. Bathory is having tranquil mark. Rachel is having disheartened. So these champions actually going to lead their nation, right? So they should have these kind of passive effects as well, but I don't see it. I mean, with Fate Core you are actually not getting charm, which is pretty amazing. Okay, but overall guys, I think maybe if they are not going to introduce this with Fate Core, then I think we will have to live with the fact that either you want to use charm where you can decrease opponent attack speed. Alright guys, so I think it's up to us whether we want to actually use Fate Core version or the normal version, because if you want to go for decreasing the attack speed of enemy, then you may have to use the original version of Genii. If you want to use this one, which will allow you to increase attack speed of allies, then you can use the Fate Core version. So being nature element, being the general, being a gold Fate Core, I would be going for this champion. I'm not sure whether I will be able to get it because I don't have a lot of Z's with me, but definitely I will try to get her with the Z's available with me. So overall guys, I think this is one of the best champion you can go for. If you have enough Z's saved up, please go for Pitiful as well. If you don't get it, then go for a Pitiful. If you have few of the Z's left, just try to save as many as you can and go for this banner. She will be one of the best investment you can do in this particular game. Alright guys, after this, what do we have? Supreme Queen Genii is gold rated Fate Core. Again, chance increase for recruit is 0.5%, and then you will have to summon 28 times to get this champion. Alright. Apart from this, there is exclusive weapon chance increase. As I have mentioned in my many previous videos, I don't care about exclusive weapons. I don't even go for exclusive weapons because I'm a free to play player and I like to invest only on champions. And anyways, these weapons don't give a lot of additional points to the champion, because if you see here what effects they are going to give, again attack plus 30 and combat power, you are going to get 3k. Alright, so if you have Z's or if you have enough resources available and you like exclusive weapon, I would say yeah, go ahead and try to get exclusive weapons as well. But for free to player, I would say just skip this part. It doesn't even matter, because anyways, if you have the champion, even any fated equipment or weapon will do just fine. Alright guys, so that's it for this video. If you haven't already subscribed to my channel, please hit that subscribe button. Thanks a lot guys, see you next time.